Peace. Welcome to Faith Expressions. I have here a rosary beads because I would like us to talk and reflect about the Holy Rosary. So I would like us to take 5 points. The first is history. In the development of praying of the Holy Rosary, in the church history, even at the very early Christianity, there was already the use of prayer beads. So the early Christianity, especially during the monastic life and monastic movements, they were praying with beads. The other point in history is that the praying of the rosary is said to have been revealed through a vision by the Blessed Virgin Mary herself to Saint Dominic. And so from Saint Dominic comes to us with the idea of praying the Holy Rosary and with the formulation of the prayers of the Holy Rosary that are in it in time. Of course, there are other saints related to the praying of the Rosary. But there is a consistency of the mention of Saint Dominic. The other point of history that we can mention is the Battle of Lepanto. Because in 1571, Pope Pius V ordered all faithful in the Christendom to pray the rosary for the victory over the invading Moors. And so there is the Battle of Lepanto and the victory of that battle in Lepanto. And that is why October 7 is the proclamation of the Feast of Our Lady of Victory, which we now know Our Lady of the Holy Rosary, because of the praying of the Holy Rosary through the intercession of the Blessed Mother to have victory over that battle. Now, so with that, universally, there was already this praying of the Holy Rosary. And then, even coming now to more recent history, Father Patrick Peyton has this movement and has this encouragement, especially in the families, to pray the rosary in the families daily. Because the saying goes, the family that prays together stays together. And so in history as well, and this I conclude this part, the Blessed Mother Mary appeared in Lourdes, appeared in Fatima. She encourages the praying of the Holy Rosary. This is for the sanctification of lives of peoples, for the salvation of humanity. I would like us to take this into account, that indeed there is a rich history with the praying of the Holy Rosary. And this makes us be inspired in praying of the Holy Rosary. The second point is on the importance of prayer itself. As a prayer, this is very important because with the praying of the Holy Rosary, we can learn many other prayers. Because within the prayer of the Holy Rosary are the prayers, the Our Father, the Lord's Prayer, the praying of the adoration and praises to the Blessed Trinity, glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, the praying of the Apostles' Creed. Now, there is also the praying of the litany of the Blessed Mother Mary, which is also a prayer, a litany, from the early Christianity. Towards the end of the praying of the Holy Rosary, many times this is omitted, but this is a Marian prayer that has been there even from the second century, the Subtum Presidium Confugimus. We fly unto you, O Virgin Mother of God. This is a small prayer to the Blessed Mother Mary, and it is in this prayer. Of course, the praying of the Hail Mary, which is the prayer taken from the Gospel, the words of Gabriel, the Archangel Gabriel, and the words of Elizabeth. So as a prayer itself is rich in learning many prayers, this is a prayer of many prayers. And so it is beneficial for the Christian to pray the rosary, because with the praying of the rosary, he or she prays other prayers. And with the idea of prayer, praying is conversation with God. So, praying, we talk at the same time with the words of the prayers themselves. We listen to God. We reflect on the words that we listen as we speak to them, because they are themselves messages from God. And as we meditate and reflect on the words that we say, on the mysteries that we say, the message behind the words that we recite. And so this is a manner of praying wherein we pray orally, we pray mentally, we meditate, we reflect, we contemplate, we see what is happening by the words that we recite and by the message behind the words. And very rich in meaning and sense and value as a prayer itself, because this is a prayer with many prayers. The third point is the doctrinal importance, the catechetical importance. You see, in the history of the church, in the early Christianity, there were people who cannot read. There were people who cannot know, therefore, the doctrines and the prayers by reading, because they don't know how to read. So, first and foremost, in order that a faithful may know the doctrines and the prayers, then they are presented to us by formulas or formulae of prayers. We repeat them. And so the person, even if the person doesn't know how to read, now will know the Lord's Prayer because of the praying of the rosary. Will know the mysteries or the events connected to Jesus Christ in the work of salvation because of the praying of the rosary. So there is the presentation through the rosary, catechetically and doctrinally, about the passion, the death, the resurrection, about the doctrine of the Blessed, in relation to the Blessed Mother Mary, the assumption of the Blessed Mother, in relation to the Holy Spirit, the descent of the Holy Spirit. There are many doctrinal contents of praying of the rosary that the person, the faithful, can encounter and can know about. Whether we know how to read or we do not know how to read, the person has the capacity, has the access to the doctrines and to the catechisms about our faith. Or the fourth idea is the Marian importance. There is a Marian stamp, so to say, into this, because this is a prayer dedicated by the Mother Church, by all of us, to the Blessed Mother Mary. How can I explain this? The mediator between God and man is only one, Jesus Christ. The intercessor between God and man is only one, Jesus Christ. But he shared, he let others participate, this being mediator, this being intercessor, to all of us, the faithful, to all of us who believe. Now, who is the directly connected to Jesus Christ, other than the Blessed Mother Mary, his mother? So for us, we are connected to Jesus Christ. But is our connection to Jesus Christ better and goes beyond the relationship of Mary to Jesus Christ? No. And that is why the Blessed Mother Mary is unique kind, special way of intercessorship, because she is the mother of her son. And in the Bible, the Blessed Mother Mary in the Gospel of St. John, interceded for the couple at the wedding of Cana, saying, "Son, they have no more wine." The power of intercession of the Blessed Mother Mary. And so the praying of the Holy Rosary has a Marian stamp, so to say, a Marian mark, because this is in veneration, in honor, and in dedication to the uniqueness of the relationship of the Blessed Mother Mary to her Son. We go to Jesus through Mary. To Jesus through Mary. And so, to God the Father through the Son. Jesus Christ himself said that. So, we do not substitute the mediatorship and the intercessorship of Jesus Christ to the Father. But he also does not hinder the other forms, ways of intercession and mediatorship, because they all participate in his own mediatorship. The Blessed Mother Mary cannot mediate or intercede by her own merit, because she has no merit at all by her own self. She has merit because of her Son, Jesus Christ. And the last importance, the last part, is the importance of praying of the Holy Rosary as a family. You know, it takes only about 15 minutes to pray the Holy Rosary. This is a good way to pray as one family. The family that prays together stays together, as what Father Patrick Peyton used to say. The praying of the Holy Rosary can be prayed as a community, the family of the parish, or a family at home. Praying of the Holy Rosary, very important. The conclusion I would like us to have is, let us respond to the will of the Blessed Mother Mary to pray the Rosary, being edified by our prayer life, so that our journey of spiritual life may flourish. Our journey of spiritual life as a church, as a family, may also thrive.